everyone, and welcome to the channel. In today's video, we'll be going over how to use the join clause in SQL. I'll be using pgAdmin, which is the database management system for PostgreSQL. I do have some other videos on PostgreSQL on how to download it, how to add data to your database, and intro to the select statement, so check any of those out if you're interested. But today's video will be focusing on the join clause, so let's get right into it. So I have three tables in my database, and to keep it nice and simple, I have them up in Excel so it's easier to visualize. So we have sales order or sales overview table, and then a sales order table and a client table. So we have the sales overview table, which has a sales order, client ID. So in SQL, you want to join one table to another using a column, and that's how the join works, by finding values in one column and matching them to another column in another table. So just to visualize this, we'll have the sales order number, which will be the same as this sales order number. So now we can connect this table to this table. And you are doing this when you have a ton of data to simplify and to keep the database running and, you know, have it run the most efficiently. So we also have this column, client ID, in this table. So we can highlight this a different color. And then we also have the client ID in this color. So as you can see, this table connects to both of these tables. So if we go into SQL, pgAdmin, we can see that we have the cell overview, the order table, and the client table. So if we want to do a simple join, such as we want to bring back this table, and we can even do something like just bringing back this order date with something like, we also want to bring back the sale total from this table. And then we also just want to know who the client is. So we can do something like this to join these tables. And the more data you have, the more useful joins are, as obviously this is not enough table data to, you know, not have an Excel. You could easily do this in Excel, but if you think about, you know, mass amounts of data, you want to pull your specific data from SQL and then, you know, maybe analyze it in Excel. So let's go ahead with, we can close this and open a new query. And so now we can start our select. But I will want to see these columns down here, so you can just look down here. So we want the order date, but since we're selecting from multiple tables, we will need to put sale overview dot the column. So this will be the table, sale overview dot the column order date. And we'll also, as we were talking about before, we'll want the sale order table. We'll just do the sale total. So this will be sale order table dot sale total. So we're pulling from this table, this column, and then something else we'll want to select will be the client name, as we talked about. So this will be client table dot client name. This table, this column. So we can do from, and we will select the initial table we are pulling from and the one that we want to join. So we will be joining from the sale overview table. So the one that you are joining from will be the table you add to the from statement. From sale overview. And so now we're going to want to join. So this is selecting everything from sale overview, at least, you know, this initial one. And so now we will want to join these other tables like we were talking about before. So we are grabbing this, and now we want to join this table and also join this table. So there are four different types of joins. It'll be an inner join, which is a normal join, or a left join, right join, and full join, which will be outer joins. But to take this one step at a time, let's just go with a basic join. And for the other ones, it's easier to visualize with data missing. So let's just do a traditional easy join where there's no data missing. So that means we can do a join in just the table we want to join. So we can do the sale order table first. So we can do sale order. And then from the join, you will want on after you add the table you want to join on. And then we can do sale overview, which is the table we're selecting data from originally, dot. Then if we look at these columns, the common column between the two tables will be sales order. So sales order, and we can type equals, and then we will also want from the sales order table the same column. So now we can put sale order table dot sale order. So that is one of the joins, and then we're going to want to join the client table. So now we can just copy and paste this to make it a little easier. This original one we'll just keep copied, but we'll do client table on. So it'll be sale overview, this table dot. And so instead of it being a sale order, now it'll be client ID equals the client table dot client ID. So now if we run this, so I did sale overview dot sales order. So I missed the S here. And if you don't get them exactly right, they will not bring back. So let's run that again. And we can see from this, we are grabbing the order date, the sale total from this other table that we joined, and then also the client name from the other table. And since we don't have any missing data, it would bring back exactly these three columns. So now you can see that we built a table with all of these different tables to make, if each table has a color, you know, now we have all three of them. And then there will also be multiple of these because every client ID happens multiple times. So this is our new table that we brought back. And now we can think about using other joins in different scenarios. But in this case, we're going to need to remove some stuff. So let's say we removed all of these, and then we can remove some of these. And then we can even remove some of these as well. So now let me update the database, and then we'll go through some of the other joins. So now that the database is updated and those tables no longer have some of those values, we can look at doing the other joins. So I do love this picture from W3Schools, which is a great resource to learn really any coding at all, but especially SQL. So this inner join, or just a regular join, will return records that have matching values in both tables. Left join, all records from the left. So that'll be when you join the tables, what you have in the left table, or like the original from table, then match records from the right. Right will be the opposite, where all records from the right and then only matched on the left. And a full join returns all records when there is match. So now to visualize this, which I do think this is a great visual, it only returns common tables. It only returns common tables from table one. And this only returns common tables from table two. And then this returns all tables, including or all results or columns in rows, but also common ones. So the way you want to picture this will be by running a join, then understanding how they work. So now if we look at what we removed, we can start by just doing a simple join where we can forget about this client table for now and just focus on bringing back this whole table and then also joining this table. So now we can run all these different joins and then we'll bring the results into Excel so you can see the difference between every join. So let's do that. So let's select all from sale overview. And then we're going to want to join sale order table. We'll do on sales order sale overview first, where the table name dot the column name equals sale order table dot sales order. So now we can run this and we can just click here, copy with headers, control C, and then we can paste it in a new tab. So now we have the results in here. And now let's run a right join. Execute that. Same thing where we can copy, paste it into Excel. Now we can do a left join. Copy and paste that into Excel, and then a full join. So let me just label these real quick, and then we'll go over the differences. Okay, so now we have them labeled as a join, a right join, left join, full join. So for this first join here, you can see where it only selected column matches. Since we just did select all, it did do this table, which would be the sales overview table, and then adding this other table, which is the sales order, but based off these columns here. So based off these columns here, you can see that it only selected the matches that happen in both tables. So a right join, and if we look back at this query, sales order table was on the right side of this equal. Since we put sale overview first, since that's where we selected from, which you can change the order, but I think if you always do it that way, it's easier to remember. So this selects this table, which will be the sale overview. And then it also selects all of these columns. But then also, if you see here where these two don't match here, it still returns them. So 85 and 84 are missing from right here, but it still adds them down here. Since we did a right join, and so on the right side of the select, it brought back this data. And a left join here, where we have all these missing numbers from the sale order table, sales overview table, still brings back all of these matches, but then also these. So this will be a left join, since on the left side of the statement we had sale overview dot sales order. So it will bring back all the non-matches as well from the left side of the join. So now we think of a full join as doing that to both. And as you can see, how these two bits down here are still added on, but now in an exact way of this table first, it brings back all of these, then we have some null space, and then it brings back the rest of this table down here. And this is exactly why you want to use different joins for different scenarios based on what you want to bring back and what you don't. And I think that this is a great way to visualize how to use either join depending on the data you're trying to bring back. And I hope this helps simplify by putting it into Excel and seeing what's added, dropped from different types of joins. But that's all I have for you in this video. I hope you enjoyed. Remember to like and subscribe. If this video helped you at all, I appreciate it a lot. And thanks for watching.